Hello, it is Monday, November 23rd, and that means two things. This podcast is being recorded on the historical lands of the Mississauga, the Anishinaabeg, the Chippewa, the Wendat, and the Haudenosaunee, and held by the Crown under the terms of the Williams Treaty and Treaty Number 13. And it is time for the Lighting Industry News Brief, brought to you by Keystone Technologies and their X-Fit Outdoor Fixtures. Small, low-profile wall packs. Super new line. Super cool. These have color select, built-in Dustodon photocells that makes them flexible. They can mount virtually anywhere because they're just so small. Again, 120 to 277-volt LED driver right in there for reliability. That's KeystoneTech.com or the link in the description, if you please. News! The EPA has stepped in to regulate UV disinfection compliance. This will fall under the Federal Insecticide, Fungicide, and Rodenticide Act. The EPA protecting indoor environments as well. The DLC is extending application deadline for SSL version 5.0. Delisting date won't change, but now you have until the end of January to apply for an update. Cooper has laid off 2% of their workforce worldwide. This is according to Edison Report. That's about 100 jobs. The AEC survey anticipates revenue losses. This is about 60 of their respondents expecting a 17% decrease in revenue. The Lux Awards winners have been named. Judges panel has named their best projects and products of 2020. On Get a Grip on Lighting, Christine Calloway is the first dedicated lighting marketing consultant, and she talks about getting the sauce running after a bit of old school nerdery. It's a fun listen. Home Depot bought HD Supply back. This is after 13 years after selling them. It turns out someone was buying HD Supply, just not Lowe's. Daylight Awards winner are profiled. This is awards for daylight research and architecture. These you can read about the winners. Lutron has named their excellent awards winners. These are dealers that were recognized at a virtual award ceremony. By 2025, there will be 26 smart cities, which is 26 more than there are today. Retrolux partners with Avion Labs. This is a sales software that includes Bluetooth lighting controls. Zigbee Alliance is taking the CHiP program into commercial spaces. That's connected home over IP. I don't think they're going to change the name because COIP just isn't as much fun. Kyocera has acquired SLC Laser. California makes gallium nitride lasers, and Kyocera makes ceramic components. The deal will go through after the regulators have a chance to go over it. Epistar is expanding their production of aluminum gallium indium platinum LEDs. These are ultra-high output diodes, and demand is rising. Nichia is the first company to license GE Current, Adaintree Company's Trigain Tech. These are for high color rendering LEDs. OLED Works is partnering with Lumenique. Probably a little too much French on that pronunciation there, but this is a lamp and fixture company in their new channel partner program. Half of drivers are afraid to drive in the dark. This is a Automotive Association survey of 16,000 drivers, and they all admit to wanting more streetlights. Signify sues Robe, a former licensee, may be in violation of 7 LED-related patents. Seoul Semiconductor has obtained a permanent injunction and recall order against K-Lite. This is a former Signify subsidiary that must recall and destroy LED lighting products sold after October 2017. Ledcom is suing Signify. They are a Texas-based company. They don't make anything. They just have patents, and they believe 5 of Signify's products violate 7 of them. In events and webinars, the DOE has set a lighting R&D workshop for February. This is a free virtual event on the 1st till the 4th. IES NYC is calling for entries in the Lumen Awards, bearing in mind that you must be in the project must have happened in New York City or been done by people who work out of New York City, but the deadline is on the 8th. The Society for Light Treatment and Biological Rhythms has set their agenda for their 2021 conference. That'll run in June next year. In market predictions, solar street lighting market will be worth $14 billion by 2030. The global LED market will generate $262 billion in revenue in 2030, and the industrial LED market will grow by $2 billion by 2024. Cree stocks have jumped 10%, and Rich Smith can explain those sudden gains to us. In rep agency updates, Zycato has named Mlazgar Associates as rep agents for Minnesota, Wisconsin, North Dakota, and South Dakota. In recommended reading, all these links are in the text version of this newsletter. Sign up in the description for that. We've got Forces of Change, Revisiting COVID-19 After 8 Months. That's a panel interview. The Wall Street Journal on upper air UVC, tuberculosis, mucus vaccines, and COVID-19. CNET reviews Cree's Max LEDs. These are classic lamp shapes, but made smart and affordable. Ted Conarth answers 5 questions about mergers and acquisitions. Nick Dunn calls for cities to embrace darkness. Steve Mesh is talking programmable LED drivers. We've got an advice on how to eliminate vertical surfaces. Marion Ebel is addressing product compliance in online retail. Craig DeLuey writing about tunable white as a tool. A design clinic from Lux Review, One Library Lit Three Ways. Maury Wright is looking forward to 2021. Alan Tula reviews in-ground uplights. 7 thoughts from Al Yuzinski after reading a sustainability reports. R&D, we've got an app that beats jet lag with lighting plans. It actually plans for your light exposure, whether you're traveling for work or pleasure, and it helps you adjust your sleep routine before and after. And a team of researchers from China and India have discovered an entirely new kind of bioluminescent mushroom. It's in the jungles of Northeast India, and it's a very interesting shade of green. In local news, Lake Geneva, Wisconsin has high school students getting into dark sky. They're measuring light pollution at the lake. Kingston, Tennessee is upgrading their streets and parks to LEDs. Durham, North Carolina's new LED streetlights might be too bright. Niles, Illinois begins streetlight replacement. Ditto for Ameren, Illinois. The mystery lights under the Coronado Bridge have been solved. It's prep for public art pieces. 3 small Ontario towns will actually install their first streetlights ever. Odenburg, Belgium's new holiday lights do not look like candles at all, and the mayor has apologized for that. The University of Texas's West Campus is solving a darkness issue by having police cruisers flashing red and blue lights all night long. That neighborhood has a high incidence of nuisance crimes, a low incidence of violent crimes, and is home to tens of thousands of people that might want to sleep, as an editorial aside. Glen Cove, New York has completed their streetlight upgrades, as has Syracuse, New York. San Diego County has a plan to reduce light pollution in Julian and Borrego Springs. Julian will be coming up on a dark sky certification. And the Lennox and Addington dark sky viewing area in Ontario is adding glowing physical distancing circles so that you may stargaze without touching anybody. In the UK, the government is seeking feedback on replaceable components from the Department of Business, Energy, and Industrial Strategy. Public input on a new statute that might require repairable or replaceable parts in lighting tech. And the Adaka German grocery chain in Germany is trying out some upper air disinfection tech in a Hamburg store. In projects, hacks, and things I think are cool, we have how to build a control system from Jeremy Day and Lumen Pulse. We have a 3D printed illuminated electric guitar. The LEDs sync up with what you're playing. A lamp made out of junk, courtesy of Laura Kampf. She'll explain how you do it. We have programmer tips on how to manage your eye health. This is very good because we're all spending a little more time staring at screens. And a little primer on how the zapper for Duck Hunt work. It's related to light, I promise. In People News, NEMA has elected Annette Clayton to the chair of the board of directors. Former GE Lighting CFO Tom Skuktak is now at Thras.io's board of directors. Candace Flippin is the CCO of Acuity. And Benoit Mandelbrot, the fractal guy, has joined the PNNL. And this has been the Lighting Industry News Brief, brought to you by Nailed. Get associated, get educated. I've been Scott Wachter. Enjoy the music. Enjoy your Monday.
Tequila Moonrise.